keep it going for David Bruce. I stole all my Rush jokes. A proud citizen of the Cherokee Nation, Indigenous Peoples in the House. That's kind of a setup. I'm totally a pander, so that's my whole act, by the way. Any land-grabbing settlers in the house tonight? That's what I thought. Over here, there's a little bit of hesitation. Is he still pandering? Yeah, pandering the shit out. A little aggressive pander. So I was walking through town today. I came across a sign that said, environmentally sensitive, please do not enter this area. And I noticed a lot of people avoided the area. They were actually respecting the sign. So it got me thinking, do we just need better signage when the Europeans came to our land? We would have totally splurged for signs. Put it in Old English, ye old sensitive area, beware. Maybe hired a pirate to throw out curses. Could have even been some souvenirs, you know, like t-shirt opportunities. You know, I came all the way to the New World and all I got was this lousy t-shirt and scurvy. Possibly cholera. I need a whole back of the shirt for that. I wanted to come clean with y'all. I'm actually a doctor of philosophy. Or as my mom says, the kind of doctor that doesn't help people. So, thanks, Mom. And so I always have this quandary when I fly on planes. Do I check doctor or mister? And it's kind of where vanity and reality collides for me. I check doctor. Am I going to walk on the plane with a white lab coat? You bet. Beat a stethoscope is a little bit over the top, but it's necessary. Why are you sitting in coach? I'm a doctor of the people, of course. And then it hits me, you know, what if there's actually a medical emergency? What if someone needs my help? You know, what can I do for someone? I'm sorry, sir, I can't help you medically, but intellectually you've been dead for years. I'd prescribe books, but you're in no condition to be right. Liven up this side of the room here. Speaking of being intellectually dead for years, I recently turned 49. And I did what a lot of guys do in their late 40s. I got a cat. Guessing by your laughter, that's not a thing. So my friends were actually ready to stage an intervention, like, you know, he's really fucking up his midlife crisis. And I told him, look, this is what a midlife crisis looks like on a budget, all right? I only had $200 for my midlife crisis. That's like, you know, half a whale-watching tour. A zip line and a cheap bottle of whiskey. That's all that I can afford, all right? You know, I even tried to go up to these fancy car dealerships, and they just sense it, you know? They just stay away from me, like, that guy has max $200. Of course, in a way, just let him eat all the free food and stuff, he'll eventually go away. He should really get a cat. So I did get this cat, and my plan with this cat is pretty simple. We're going to watch Netflix on the couch together and die quietly. Working out really well so far. It worked out well except for the fact that the cat is actually pooping in the bathtub instead of the litter box. What's the problem, right? I hear the concern. I'm hearing some life over here. I did what a lot of responsible owners would do. You want to model good behavior, right? You want to lead by example. So I started pooping in the litter box, which I thought was going well as a retraining kind of exercise, until I found out the cat is actually posting pictures of me on Instagram. The hashtags are pretty brutal. You know, like, who's domesticated now, bitch? That's what I'd expect. Cat domination, one human at a time. Where the hell does this critical ideology come from this cat that I adopted from the SPCA? I thought there'd be some loyalty there. Even more disturbing is, you know, he used some really unflattering filters on his Instagram, so it made me look really undignified. But that was the most offensive thing. So I, in response, I was thinking, what could I do? So I went to the store, and I got a sign. It said, environmentally sensitive, please stay out of this area. Seems to have worked, and hashtag shit just got real. All right, that's my time. What over.